was proposed by A. Mendel, B. Darwin, C. Lamarck, D. Karl Landsteiner. The theory of natural selection is respect to the evolution. So the father of evolution is Darwin, so which was proposed by Charles Darwin. Efforts of which of the following scientists led the government of India to set up Center for DNA Fingerprinting and Diagnostics? Options are Dr. Lalji Singh, Samir K. Brahmachari, Professor M. Vijayan, Kanuri Venkata Subbarao. This was actually done by, what was the center? It's called the CCMB, which is situated at Hyderabad, Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology. Professor Dr. Lalji Singh, who had proposed to the government that any crime scene, murder related area or site of the for crime scene, the samples can be collected in the form of blood, sperm, air, or any available material, biological material, can be collected from this crime scene that can be analyzed using the DNA fingerprint. So Professor Lalji Singh proposed that idea to the government and established a center. This center, in fact, was approved by the government because eventually this particular technology was used to identify the people who had convicted the incident of our past Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi's murder case at Sriperumbudur, Tamil Nadu. In that particular incident, the murder of Dr. Rajiv Gandhi, where the several forensic material, that material were analyzed using the DNA fingerprinting technology. So eventually this particular technology contributed very much to identify the the people who had convicted the crime. So that's how the government is very greatly approved this and establishment of the center. Which among the following is correct definition of bacteriophage? We know this particular terminology, phage, macrophage. We know macrophage in our human system. So what is the function of this phage? Here it's called as a bacteriophage. The phage is a cellular shape which engulf the other biological material. So in this case, the name it's been given for this particular organism. So in the given option, A bacteria that destroy virus, a virus that destroys bacteria, the bacteria that destroys another bacteria, a bacteria that destroys fungi. It is bacteriophage is in a virus that destroys bacteria. There are several, probably we come across tobacco mosaic virus. Tobacco mosaic virus is a bacteriophage. So there are several that Myoviridae, Cyphoviridae, and Podoviridae. It's based upon the tailoring part. The tail, which plays a major role in the movement of, the bacteriophages. A plant belonging to which of the following groups would show least adaptation to marine water among the plant kingdom? Which one shows a very poor adaptation to the marine system? The marine water is not a very normal environment, which is extreme environment, because the plant where it grows should have the salt tolerance. So among this given option, A. pteridophytes, B. gymnosperms, C. angiosperms, and D. bryophytes. The angiosperms are the recent evolution in kingdom Plantae. So they, most of them are actually the flowering plants. There are several angiosperms that actually exist in the marine ecosystem, but they are very poor in their adaptation to survive in the marine ecosystem. Which of the following groups of plants is known as Magnoliophyta? There are different taxonomic classification exists with respect to gymnosperm, angiosperm, algae, and bryophyta. So in one of the classification, this particular group otherwise is called as Magnoliophyta. Again, the answer is angiosperms, because the magnoliophyta, the why it is called magnoliophyta, among this angiosperm, the group of magnolia related species are considered to be the primitive angiosperms, which has the character with the some of the characters with gymnosperms. The gymnosperm is considered to be the ancestral to the angiosperm. So the plants which classified under angiosperms have got some similar ancestry. So the angiosperm also is otherwise called as the magnoliophyta. Which of the following bacteria forms an endosymbiotic nitrogen fixing association with roots of legumes that helps in nitrogen fixation? This question is very familiar, but we know the answer very well, which is rhizobium. The function of rhizobium, probably we discussed in the earlier classes, like they fix the freely available nitrogen from the atmosphere to the soil in the form of ammonia, and eventually that would be converted into nitrates for the plants to uptake for their growth. That's how the rhizobium plays a very major role as a symbiote, having a beneficiary advantage with the plant, like host and microbe interactions, they fix the nitrogen. Effective TB treatment, tuberculosis treatment, is difficult because of the unusual structure and chemical composition of which among the following parts of the cells of tuberculosis bacteria, which is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. What makes the Mycobacterium tuberculosis is very much resistant for any kind of treatment to eradicate? Option A of the Mycobacterium tuberculosis: cell wall, nucleus, plasma. So Mycobacterium tuberculosis, we have a very good cell wall structure. It is made up of good layer of peptidoglycans. So if any drug which has been administered for this tuberculosis treatment, they have to go through the cell wall. If the cell wall gets disintegrated, then only the drug can penetrate into the cell and it will collapse the entire organism. So which is not possible, because the diluting or breaking the cell wall of the Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which is very, and also is very important in the drug design to encounter this particular problem. So any drug, if it is administered for tuberculosis, that should go to the cell wall and disintegrate the cell wall, and also it has to perform the penetration into the cell, to the cell components, and collapse the entire system. Then only you will get the very good mortality of the Mycobacterium. Eventually you can eradicate the causing organism for the tuberculosis. So which was not possible. Cell wall is greatly made up of different structures like arabinogalactan, peptidoglycan, and also the plasma membrane, and with the acyl lipids. So the different layers of the cell wall which protects the Mycobacterium very greatly against any medicine. Which among the following bacterial cells are found in cubical packets? Tetracocci, streptococci, staphylococci, Sarsinae. This is just the arrangement of the cocci, and which cocci looks like the cubical structure. From this picture, probably you can figure it out, which is Sarsinae. The bacteria which belongs to the Sarsinae group have the cubical structure of the cocci arrangement. So the answer is Sarsinae. The gram-positive bacteria can be identified by the gram staining because of the following reasons. The cell walls have more lipids compared to peptidoglycan. The cell walls have more peptidoglycan compared to lipids. The cell's membrane has more fatty acids. The plasma has peptidoglycans. There is a great difference between gram-negative bacteria as well as gram-positive bacteria. The staining procedure also with respect to the coloration of the bacteria, and the coloration also, it's depend upon the chemical compound which is present in the particular cell wall of the bacteria, because the cell wall plays a major role that it distinguishes the gram positive and gram negative bacteria. Negative bacteria, they have the very good structure of the cell wall. So what actually makes this particular positive bacteria to be stained well. The cell walls have more peptidoglycan compared to lipids. Even in the staining procedure, whatever the stain, the histochemical stains which you use to identify in the available colony, the microbial colony, which one, whether the microbial colony has got the gram positive bacteria or negative bacteria, it depends upon the absorption of the color. But if it is red, it is gram negative. If it is blue, which is gram. The bacterium Escherichia coli is found mainly in human intestine, pteridophytes, root nodules of leguminous plants, paddy fields of nitrogen fixation. Escherichia coli is a beneficiary bacteria which found in our human intestine, because the enzyme, we know the colic acid, it's been produced by Escherichia coli, because which is very important, the presence of the colic acid, which is very important to, if the Escherichia coli population, it shouldn't increase also, it should be maintained, and also the virulence. So not the intestine, our human intestine, not only having the Escherichia coli populations, they also have some. Which among the following plays a role in production of alcohol in beer? We know that the alcohol fermentation, the starting material is yeast, the yeast fermentation. Through the yeast fermentation, you have to provide the yeast that will facilitate the entire process of the beverages. So you will get at the end product the alcohol. The percentage of the alcohol, the production, it depends upon the substrate what you provide and the amount of yeast which have been used in the complete brewing process. Sorry, here again wrongly that has been placed. The answer is yeast. Which among the following are called scavengers of ecosystem? Bacteria, fungi and bacteria, algae, fungi and bacteria, none of the above. Decomposes under the particular criteria. If you are considering the microbes, definitely the fungi and bacteria plays a major role as a scavengers in our ecosystem. Whatever the dead material, whatever the components of the ecosystem ended their life cycle, that needs to be disintegrated, that needs to be the breakdown process should be taken care by the decomposers. So the decomposition will be successfully carried out by fungi and bacteria. Actinomycetes are good source of which of the following? Actinomycetes is a group of fungi under the particular kingdom fungi kingdom. We know basidiomycetes, which are mushrooms, actinomyces. These are all the certain groups of fungal. These are the one actually provided the antibiotics first to the humankind. So penicillin, streptomyces, all these fungus belongs to the group actinomycetes. Which of the following organism grows on common bread? If you leave the bread, fungal growth, that is due to the proliferation of mucor. The mucor are the one, the black spot. Penicillin, which is used as an antibiotic, is obtained from, definitely it is fungi. The penicillin was the first antibiotic, and then also the one of the accidental discovery. The nutritional supplements spirulina, chlorella and vitamin C supplement, Dunaliella, are actually all this group, spirulina species, chlorella species and the Dunaliella, these are be considered as the vitamin C supplement, are actually come from whether it is algae, lichens, probiotics, bryophytes. All these are belongs to the group of algae. That too, that belongs to green algae, which are the rich source of minerals, in fact, and also one of the very important vitamin C supplement. In gymnosperms, seeds are, so the plant actually is divided into two in major as a higher plants, I would say. The lower plants are bryophytes, pteridophytes. that exist. But when you talk about the higher plants, the gymnosperms and angiosperms, what is the major difference between gymnosperms and angiosperms? Gymnosperms are open-seeded. Angiosperms are closed seeds. So the answer is gymnosperms are always naked. So they don't have proper ovarian structure. Like they can't keep their corpus intact within the seed. They don't have such structure. So the seeds are naked. So that's why it is called in Latin, gymno means naked. Gymno means naked. Sperms means seed. Naked seeds. That's why it is called gymno. Which among the following kinds of roots are found in sugarcane? We know it's very well that at the first node of, when you look at the base of the sugarcane, at the first node, you'll find the anchors. The root like coming out from the first node, probably you would have seen the columns during the Pongal. The down part of the sugarcane, if you tend to observe, probably you would see just from very beginning of the first node will have lot of roots. Those all the roots will just go to the soil and anchor into the soil to give the mechanical support to the stem. So these roots are called stilt roots. The prime importance of the roots to give the mechanical support, since there are columnar plants and they don't have a branching pattern for them to mechanically support. So the stilt roots give the very good mechanical support for them to avoid the avoid against the wind velocity. In context with biology, which among the following is a zoophyte? Zoophyte are one of the primary consumer in marine ecosystem. We have actually come across this particular terminology. We have phytoplanktons, zooplanktons, zoophytes. So zoophytes are considered to be the primary consumer. So the options are here: a plant that resembles an animal, an animal that resembles a plant that grows on an animal that grows on a plant. The answer is an animal that resembles like a plant. An animal that resembles a plant. Most of the porifera, a group of animals, they will have some of the coral reefs are the best example. Some of the coral reefs look, they'll just give rise to the branching pattern. Stem look like a stem, look like a branches of the plant, but they are animals. They have the poriferous nature where they will respire and they will do all the metabolic activity based upon that. The onion, daffodil, tulip are which kind of stems? What kind of stems they have? How many of you have seen the onion? Probably you will easily come to know the answer. Whether it is called bud, whether the stems called bulb or cladophyll or none of the above. In fact, the stem of these plants, most of them are actually comes from the family Liliaceae. So these group of plants, Liliaceae, the family Liliaceae plants, stems greatly modified into bulbs. The answer is bulbs. They have the beautiful daffodils, but they will have whatever you see at the aerial part above on the ground are the flower pots. The stem-like structures, probably you could see here, stem-like structures are the spadix. Spadix means the flower stalk. It's not a stem. So the stems are actually modified into bulb. It will be there underneath the. The nematophores are negatively geotrophic roots which grow upward and meant for gaseous exchange. These are characteristics of dash. Nematophores, these are the very good ecological adaptation, and also they grow against the ground. They won't go inside the ground. They'll come out of the ground. And it is actually, this particular adaptation is for gaseous exchange. That's why the nematophores are otherwise called as respiratory roots. So where will you find the respiratory roots in the given options? Halophytes, heliophytes, xerophytes, lithophytes. The best example probably I'll show the mangrove ecosystem, where you will find the nematophores. So these are the stilt roots, but underneath you would find there are the roots will coming out of the coming out from the ground. These are all not what I'm showing here, it's not a nematophores. These are all the stilt roots, but what will have from the ground, from which part coconut coir is obtained. The Tenganar we used to call in Tamil the coconut coir. The coconut coir is come from the mesocarp region of the coconut. It's a very good fibrous material. It can be used in many purposes and properties, and also one of the prime exporter of coconut coir is India in the world. Especially the Kerala state exports the large amount of coconut coir to the rest of the world. Rafflesia is the plant with the largest flowers and found in many parts of Southeast Asia. It is a Rafflesia, whether it is a mangrove, ornamental plant, parasitic plant or carnivorous plant, which is a saprophytic plant. Saprophytic means it will have a parasitic nature. This will grow, it's the largest flower in the world, which grow on the organic dead matters. The forest floor, there are the litters will be there on the forest floor. These particular saprophytes will grow on top of it. So it will draw the nutrients from the dead, decayed vegetational matter, litters. So that's why it is called a saprophyte, and also it is also called as a parasitic plant, because that doesn't give any beneficiary account for the host. The monocarpic plants produce flowers only monocarp. Carpic means only once they reproduce and produce the siblings in a lifetime. So the answer is once in lifetime. There are several palms are monocarpic. The best example is there in your everyone's home garden, which is banana. But banana we can't consider as a plant, because banana culms, it will keep on growing. And one end, but with respect to the culm, it's monocarpic, but its plant is not a monocarpic. In this case, the entire plant itself, in a particular individual itself, is a monocarp. So it will grow for several years, about 80, 90 years, but end of their life cycle, they'll give us the flowers and they'll reproduce, they'll set the seeds and disperse the seeds, and eventually the vegetational part will undergo. Anemophily is pollination by animo in Latin. It defines as wind. So certain plants do the wind disposal of the seeds. So that's why it's called anemophily, because wind carries the seeds from one place to the another place for the population establishment. If one place produces seeds in one particular place, it will be carried by the wind in several kilometers distance, and they'll set up that other population, or they'll set up the it's completely mediated by wind. That's why it's called anemophily. The hard part of a stem of a plant is because of whatever the hard part. When you talk about the timber value, the timber value is determined by the hardwood. It's determined greatly by the hardwood. The hardwood is nothing but the xylem, which transports the water that will undergo the secondary structure. The secondary xylem are translated into the hardwood of the any wood material. So the xylem are the one, it's turned to be the hard part of the stem when it undergo the secondary structure. The cork cells are impervious to water. Which among the following is responsible to give this quality to cork? Cellulose, cutin, suberin, glucose. Cork is nothing but we'll find it as the periderm part, the outer layer of the plant. We'll find the cork layer. It's nothing but it's all otherwise called as a cork cambium. It will have the deposition of the compound called suberin. So what the function of the suberin? Due to the accumulation of suberin in the periderm part, which will resist the plant for desiccation. If the plant exists in the high water pressure zone, or like example in aquatic system, it has to undergo the pressure, hydro pressure. So to avoid that hydro pressure, the suberin, it plays this particular function. It is impervious to water. It's resistant to water. So the plant cell will not undergo any desiccation. So it's been greatly adapted with the presence of the suberin. In which of the following plants you can find leguminoglobin? Leguminoglobin, the terminology itself, is a protein found in leguminous plants. The soybeans is the best example for having leguminoglobin. The beans, you know, the pulses, pulses are very rich in protein. With respect, in general, the pulses will have a high amount of albumin. But the leguminoglobin, the another protein also very much found in several groups of the leguminous plants. In which among the following categories, Nepenthes caseana or Indian pitcher plant can be placed under the given options? Saprophyte, xerophyte, insectivorous, halophyte. The Nepenthes plant, which is a pitcher plant, it's the insectivorous plant. So Nepenthes naturally, which is not the autotrophic plant. Generally, the plants are autotrophic. They do their photosynthesis by their own for their survival. But Nepenthes caseana is heterophyte, which is depends on the behavior of the insectivorous nature. They are growing in a very poor soil, very, very much sterile soil. We don't have much nutrients. So inavailability of the nutrients in their own habitat, they have to draw the nutrients from their foraging behavior, by their foraging behavior. So they don't have autotrophic in their survival. So they capture the insects, they digest them by having the pitcher adaptation. So when you look at this picture, it's like a when the insects approaches close to this plant, because of the color ornamentation, it will be captured or it will be trapped inside. So the insects were trapped inside the picture. You will have acidic liquid that will digest the insects, and the nutrients can be easily drawn by the plants. Chlorophyll absorbs which of the following wavelength of the sunlight? Chlorophyll in green color, which absorbs the light at two different spectrum. One is red, the another one is blue. But chlorophyll only absorbs at two different spectrum, which is red and blue, but it reflects the light at green wavelength. So that's how this particular graph shows. It absorbs at blue and red, but it reflects at green wavelength. So it will have two different wavelengths for the absorbance, and for the particular wavelength they have got at the green color. That's why we could see the plants are in green color, because of the